What's a real life example of foreshadowing that has happened to you?
I applied to an internship I really wanted and I knew they'd get back to me in February. The month was almost over and I made a sulky, resigned comment to one of the professors who wrote me a recommendation that had clearly been rejected or I would have heard back by now. I then returned to my room and checked my email and my acceptance letter is in the inbox, so I grabbed my laptop and raced back to her office to show her. Not sure if this counts, maybe it was more of a coincidence, but years ago on my 23rd birthday my best friend and I went to a Mexican restaurant that was having a live rap / poetry contest. In order to get in you had to be checked by security. Yes, this place was ghetto but we felt safer so we thought. We were sitting at a booth for a good hour and my best friend had to use the bathroom. As we're touching up our makeup, taking selfies with other people in the bathroom, my best friend from the stall declares that she needs a tampon. Well, the tampon was in my car. So we walk out of the restaurant and go searching for a tampon for her. We're both searching through the car when we hear pop 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 coming from the restaurant. We both look at each other and look back again at the restaurant to see people running out. We didn't say a word and just jumped in the car to get away. As we pulled out to the street we see police cars speeding to get to our destination. Now anytime someone says they need something from the car, I always leave the building to go with them. A week ago, Monday, I had a dream that I went to work and got incredibly sick and my boss called my mom, sister, brother to pick me up. They were really upset when they arrived and asking how did I get sick, but I woke up before I told them. I told my mom my dream and she said it might not be me but someone in the family who's about to get sick. By Friday my sister told mom, brother, same ones in the dream, that my niece got COVID and like my dream they are really upset and trying to figure out how she got it. I think this ain't a foreshadow or something but. When I was a kid I told my auntie her house would burn and firefighters with big trucks would arrive. I had a fascination of boy to being a firefighter as a kid and at the same day a fire happened in her house and what I said became real, the cause was a fan overheated. I know this story sounds fishy but it's real. I had a dream this summer before college about packing crates like when we moved back from overseas. On the wooden moving crates was written the word terrapin. A couple of months later, at the freshman college mixer, I met and ended up dating a guy who worked for a moving company during the summer. He was a Grateful Dead fan and used to write Terrapin on the crates. His favorite album was Terrapin Station. Went through a horrific divorce from my husband of 17 years. I was truly depressed and scared at forging a new life from scratch. My friend tried to get me into online dating, but I refused. She signed me up anyway, without pictures or info and just told me to check it out, you might find some rich foreign hottie who worships you. She knew how much I love to travel. I am in Eastern Washington State, there is not much of an international dating scene here. It's mostly white supremacists, white trash or country bumpkins. On the nights I was in busy crying, I would scroll through to see different men and lost even more hope. One night, a guy pops up, Cuban, super handsome, in town for a temporary job assignment and there was something about his eyes. I just drowned in them. We messaged back and forth. Had our first date 6 years ago yesterday, have traveled the world together, have never had a single fight as we communicate beautifully together and are deeply in love. I have these dreams where I see a figure clad in black robes and those dreams always come true. Never big things, like, me running to class and my mates shouting things as we ran. Legit happened the next day at lunch. Then a few years back, I had another dream. Of my mom refusing the offer, of someone I couldn't see, to get her a chair. So she awkwardly sat down on the steps and I had a little giggle. Kicker is about 2 years later, and yes I always remember these dreams, they just kept getting burned in my mind for some reason. I was at my auntie and uncle's house warming. Never been there before. I'm sitting in this chair when this exact scene plays out. The whole view was exactly the same. The wall, the plank floor, the barbecue in the background, the voice. Even the clothes my mom was wearing and the noises she made. A friend of mine has similar foreshadowing dreams. And he draws. When he was about 16 he drew pictures of the three kids he had in his dream. He's 40-ish now. I called bullshit when he told me that they looked the same as the kids he had now, and I was shocked when he pulled out a used and abused art book with yellow pages and showed me the pictures. They looked exactly like Max and Ebony. He never thought he'd have the third kid because his ex didn't want another one and that kid was blonde hair blue eyes, whereas himself and his ex were brown eyes and brown hair. But now he's with a woman, who wants kids, and has blonde hair and blue eyes. so I guess we'll just have to wait and see, guys. I borrowed my friend's car to pick up groceries. As I walked out the door, I said as a joke, "I'm off to go crash your car." I crashed his car. In early January of 2020, literally New Year's Day, I visited China to help run the math competition. Before I left, my mom bought some masks to take with me because of the air pollution in Beijing. When I came back, I hadn't used the masks because they don't actually do much to help with air pollution, and no one I was with wore one when I was there, except one friend bought some masks in China as a joke. My mom told me she'd take the masks for the store for a refund. This was mid-late January 2020. I agreed, since I figured there's no way I'd need a mask for anything anytime soon. Guess what happened then? When I was 2, my mom asked where my dad was, and I said daddy dead. He died a week after. Was at a house show. It was after the show died down, and there were just the people that lived there, close friends, and a few stragglers. One of those stragglers was a wasted girl that was passing out on the floor. Another straggler was doing that thing creepy dudes do to come off like a hero to some girl at a party in the hopes that she'll fuck him. He was being super creepy to her, so we threw him the fuck out. He was like, "There are no buses running." We reminded him that he made the choice to not leave earlier and to deal with it. Anyways, a few months later, that dude raped a different girl. Oh boy, do I have the perfect one. Early on in my career, I met a very modest and respectable older engineer. He took a liking to me for some reason and taught me a lot. In fact, sometimes he would give me some of his own designs and tell me to run with it, and that he didn't want credit. I always gave him credit though. One day he explained a bit of the company history. He used to run the business, but another company bought them and kicked him out of his office. He had a choice to return to engineering, or to leave. The thought of such a thing just blew my mind. Then the exact same thing happened to me 11 years later. Exact. Apparently it happens quite often with mergers, takeovers, investment firm buyouts. It's a shame. One minute you feel like you are standing on a total solid foundation, and in a matter of days it has just crumbled to dust. As a preteen, I had a bit of the not like other girls thing happening. I had a hard time making friends, and as many of my classmates were all about boy bands, I thought I was somehow superior to them for not being caught up in it. In secret, I had a fascination with a young female pop star. I would hunt out and carefully clip out photos of Hillary Duff and kept a scrapbook. In later years, after puberty and realizing I'm a lesbian in life and all that, I realized that was it. That was my baby lesbian awakening, and I made fun of my classmates for effectively being the same little creeps to boy bands. Anyway, that seemed pretty obvious later. I broke a mirror the first day I moved into my current apartment. I'm not usually superstitious, but I recall thinking, well, that seems like a bad omen. I've lived here for almost 4 years now, and every single downstairs neighbor I've had has been super loud and disrupted my sleep and mental health, including one who would scream at his girlfriend all the time. Trying to move elsewhere this summer if I can afford it. When I was a freshman in high school, there was this guy I liked, and my brother didn't care for him much. I told my brother, "Oh come on, it's not like I'm going to marry him." This guy and I dated all through high school. Got married right out of high school and have been married for 25 years now. Every single time I set an item down, like AirPods for example, in an odd place and I think to myself I shouldn't leave it there, I'm going to forget where it is, forget to take it with me, the cat will knock it over. I never listen to that little voice, and it is correct every time. I have the perfect example. A couple months ago, I got a dozen people together for a friend's birthday at a restaurant, two tables of six for COVID protocols etc. At the beginning of the night, one of the girls leaned on one of the end tables and it rocked a little bit, shaking her drink and giving her a good little scare. I immediately said to everyone, "That's going to be a problem at some point tonight," with a laugh. Well, a few hours go by, everyone's pretty drunk, and sure enough I'm sitting at that end table. I forgot it tilted and leaned on it to stand up, and caused four glasses to fall over, which shattered all over the floor and got myself all sticky with beer and rum and coke and whatnot. I just laughed it off though and gave an extra big tip. Luckily everyone was able to have a chuckle at my expense. Whenever I used to go out on a date with someone who later turned out a psycho, I got an injury early on, light cuts, mostly bleeding injuries. Still have most of the scars, small ones. Due to this omen, I recognized the one when it was totally different, but that's a whole nother story.
with